never seen so many of my idols here in one studio.
Unbelievable.
It's great.
It's been a gas from beginning to end.
My fellow cohorts in the victimless crime of rock and roll.
If I had a party in my backyard, this is who I'd invite anyway.
We're all here and it's like one happy family.
It's like one big family, you know.
One big black leather metallic family.
Yeah.
This project took place in the minds of two people first. That was our bass player, Jimmy Bain, and the guitar player in Dio as well, Vivian Campbell. And it came about because of a radiothon that the station KLOS held for 2 days in Los Angeles. And we all took part in it. Jimmy and Viv, in particular, had gone to the station and noticed the lack of people representing our genre of music, our kind of stuff.
The music that's going to be created tonight is going to reach an entirely new and different audience. And what people are finding is that this seems to be a time in history when people are not just directed inward, that they're looking for a way to be directed outward. And when they have the people that they look to leading the way to do that, that they are in fact going to follow.
The thing that we're demonstrating, I think, is the power of music as a social maker of social change. Music really can move people to action and can change the course of society and of history. It's kind of neat.
I think there's a lot of situations going on in the world right now, without getting too political, where people should become more aware. And if we can accomplish that here doing that this evening, I think we've set out and accomplished what we set out to do.
Musically, it's just a straightforward heavy metal song, very melodic, but Vivian and I have written the music for it.
I was real flattered when Jimmy and Vivian from my Rodney Hill's band phoned me up and asked me if I wanted to do it, you know, so I said to him, you know, I'm on 24-hour call as soon as you got it ready.
A lot of people involved in this all know each other, and we've probably rubbed elbows and worked together on different occasions before, but never for so worthy of a cause. And everybody who's involved has donated not only their time, but their efforts, their energies, and probably a small part of their soul and heart.
Actually sounds quite good. Are you comfortable with it?
I arrived here from New York without having heard the music, and arrived at the hotel and heard a copy of the track and the melody. Came down here and lo and behold, there's everyone from the dawn of man in the heavy rock area. We can be strong. We are
fire and stone. The image tagged upon us is unfortunate because it's not really very true, but we were able to turn a few heads just during the making of the project at A&M.
We can be strong. We are fire and stone.
Hold on. Stone fell on my voice.
Now we can be strong. We are fire and stone. And we all want to touch a rainbow.
Thanks a lot for the vote of confidence in there, guys.
Now we can be strong. We are fire.
It's great that I get to be asked to sing for a good cause like this, because it just shows that rock and roll is good and positive and help people in many more ways than just going to concerts. So we're helping to feed people and we're helping to make the world a better place. So that's a good thing.
We are calling you.
like that?
Don't be quite so smooth on some of the lines, all right?
Not so smooth.
The idea of the song being that it's pretty aggressive because it's a pretty awful thing that we're dealing with.
I know.
You know, and I liked the touch of the rainbow. That was really nice when you went softly into the rainbow. That's nice. Little things like that, but don't smooth it out too much.
I took that off one of your older albums, you know. That phrase was one of your older albums.
I took that in. Okay, I'll try it again.
GQ called back. They said forget it, Don.
When's this album coming out?
We can be strong, we are fire and stone, and we all want to touch the rainbow. The singers and songs will never change it alone, so we are calling you. Yes, we keep calling you.
Dude, nice one, man.
They asked us to do the leads, but like I said before, you know, I didn't want to blow these other blokes away. You know, I've been doing this a lot longer than they have. You know, I've got pipes I haven't used yet.
He could break the board.
I haven't located them yet.
He could break the board in there. You know, yeah, it's okay. Really, it's an act of mercy to the engineers, yeah, that he doesn't sing lead.
This is the only sector of music that hasn't really done anything in the form of relief for what's going on over in Africa. And it's just a joy to be involved, you know.
Rock and roll is for the kids, it's for everybody. It's an attitude more than anything else, and some people just don't understand that. But we're all down here together to show that we care just as much as everybody else does about famine and people that are in trouble and need our help. And we know that we can do our part and make it worthwhile. And we're all here, and it's like one happy family. It's great. It's a good vibe down here.
These children are starving, and they need to fill their little bellies and their little hearts with hope that somebody cares.
We can be strong, we are fire and stone. Dean Martin in it there, isn't he? We can be strong, we are fire and stone. Whoops.
We can be strong, we are fire and stone.
I like it myself.
Okay.
I like it.
Thank you, Ronnie.
We are magic in the night. We are shadow, we are light. We are forever you and I. We are forever you and I.
Right. He's someone who started a dream with me, and the dream of the band that we put together, and now started another dream that he's involved me in as well, and a lot of other people. So I think, you know, it goes without saying how good a player he is, but I think it's more should be said about how much he cares and how much he cared enough to start all of this.
biggest problem is probably going to be finalizing what we have, and we were going to have so many guitar solos, and all these guys, I mean, they're all burning, all going for it, and all playing really, really well, and it's going to be very, very hard to decide, you know, what to use, because they're all putting so much into it, the whole solo, they're all going for it.
Malmsteen person, you know, and once you get the hang of his name, you know, he's really incredible. I really did. I bought his album the other day, and I threw my guitar out. I said, why bother, you know, use it as a coffee table, you know, because I can't play the thing like that. He's great. I like the way he puts Yngwie J. Malmsteen on his album, so you know, you don't confuse him with all the other Yngwie Malmsteens in the business. Oh yes, sounds a bit like rock and roll, doesn't it?
Charge out of playing with all these other guitar players on here. The the note density on this recording has got to be some kind of a record.
Everybody in the world, I think, at this point in time, is like clamoring for an opportunity to become involved, to try and right any wrong that they can, and to apply their energies into, you know, getting some corn to the starving folks and getting some problems solved over, especially in Ethiopia and around the world, not only in the foreign countries, but right here in the good old U.S. of A.
Okay, we'll try another one then. We'll try another one.
Heavy metal people do have feelings, and a lot of us have kids. And you could imagine if your kids were starving, you'd want to help too. I mean, we're not these evil people just out for sex and drugs and money. We don't sit back in limousines and count our money each night. It's you know, this is a job too, and this is one way where our fame can help people.
Very nice, thank you.
To me, it's a good cause because I've always been involved with UNICEF and helping people, you know, get food and find water for people and things like that. So I think it's a great cause to put heavy metal and hard rock, heavy bands, all that stuff on the map.
In the world. Good on you.
After you stop listening to this record, to what I say, people will still be starving, and only you can change it. So if this is the vehicle to make you think and to make you help another human being, then so be it. We've done our part. Now we should all continue to do our parts forever.